sixth part of the fourth chapter, parts and wholes of class 5 subject mathematics. Let's start the class. Now let's know the topics of today's class. So the first topic is types of fraction, and the second is Kirti's shopping list. Now come to the first topic, which is types of fractions. So in types of fractions, we have taken three types of fraction. So the first is proper fraction, second is improper fraction, and the third is mixed fraction. Now come to the first, which is proper fraction. So what is a proper fraction? So it's very easy. A proper fraction is a fraction which is less than 1. How? Let me clear this with a picture. For example, here we are taking one circle. Okay, it is a whole. Whole means one. And now I am dividing this whole circle into two equal parts. Okay, so you can see that this color part is 1 upon 2. Okay, and this 1 upon 2 is less than the whole part. Okay, for that we can say that 1 upon 2 is a proper fraction. Similarly, 3 upon 6, 4 upon 6, 8 upon 10, these all are the examples of proper fractions. Or in another way, you can say that proper fractions are fractions whose numerators, okay, are less than the denominators. Okay, how? Here you can see that in 3 upon 6, here the numerator is 3 and the denominator is 6. So here you can see that 3 is less than 6. So these type of fractions are known as proper fractions. Now come to the improper fractions. So what is the improper fraction? So it's very easy. The fractions which are more than 1 are equal to 1. For example, it is a circle and it is completely filled. Okay, so you can write this is a 1 upon 1, or you can write 6 upon 6. Clear? Or you can write 9 upon 4, or you can write 8 upon 3. So this type of fractions are improper fractions, because these are more than 1 or equal to 1. Clear? Or in another way, you can say that the improper fractions are fractions whose numerator is greater than the denominators. Here you can see in 9 upon 4, the numerator is 9, which is greater than the denominator 4. So this type of fractions are known as improper fractions. Now come to the next fraction, which is mixed fraction. So what do you mean by mixed fraction? Let me take a number. Let me take a whole number, 4. Okay, and one fraction number, 3 upon 2. So this type of fraction are known as mixed fractions. So what is the definition of mixed fraction? So here you can see 4 is a whole number, clear, and 3 upon 2 is a fraction number, clear. So mixed fraction means a whole number and fraction number makes mixed fraction number, clear. Yes, and when you will solve this fraction, you will get one improper fractions. So how to solve this? You will just multiply the whole number with the denominator. So 4 2 is 8. Then you will add with the numerator, that is 3. So 8 plus 3, 11 upon 2. Now come to the next topic, which is Kirti's shopping list. But before going to Kirti's shopping list, I want to clear that you have to know that how to convert mixed fraction into improper fraction. Let me clear this once again. So I am taking here a mixed fraction number, 2 whole, 6 upon 8. Clear? So we have to convert this mixed fraction into improper fraction. So how you will do this? It's very easy. You will just multiply the whole number, which is 2, to the denominator, that is 8. So 8 to the 16. Clear? Then the numerator, which is 6, you will add with 16. So 16 plus 6, 22. So it will be your numerator upon the denominator you will write here. So 22 upon 8. Clear? You have to know this solution. For that, let me take one more, 2 whole, 1 upon 4. So how you will get the improper fraction? Yes, you will just multiply this whole number with the denominator 4. So 2 4 ja, it is 8, and 8 then you will add with 1. So 8 plus 1, it is 9. So 9 upon 4. Okay, now it is clear that how to convert mixed fraction into improper fraction. Yes, now we can solve the problems based on mixed fraction and improper fractions. So now come to Kirti's shopping list. So here is the topic. So at first we will read it. So Kirti's shopping list. Look at the yellow price list. So dear students, here you can see in this yellow table we have the price list. So left side we have items, that is tomato, potato, onion, carrot and gourd. And in right side we have price in rupees per kilogram. So tomatoes, the cost of 1 kilogram tomato is 12 rupees, cost of 1 kilogram potato is 10 rupees, 1 kilogram onion cost is 16 rupees, similarly 1 kilogram carrots cost is 18 and gourd is 8 rupees per kilogram. So in this way you have to properly study the table, then you can solve some questions. So now come to the questions. How much does 2 kilogram tomatoes cost, half kilogram tomatoes cost, and here we have 2 and whole 2 whole 1 upon 2 kilogram of tomato, here we have 3 whole 1 upon 2 kilogram potato, here we have 1 whole 1 upon 4 kilogram carrot, and in this way we have many questions. So one by one we will solve these all questions. So here I have the solution of these all questions. So now come to the Kirti's shopping list. Yes, and you have properly studied this table, which is a shopping list. Tomatoes, potatoes, onion, carrot, you have known the rate. Okay, now come to the next. The first question was find the cost of 2 kilogram of tomato. So here we have the question. Yes, you can see I have the question here and the solution in your notebook, how you will make solutions for this all. So here is the solution and step by step you will note down it in your notebook. So first write solution, then given, and first here you have to understand the question, that what is the question. So in the question that is asking find the cost of 2 kilogram tomato. Okay, 2 kilogram tomatoes cost you have to find. And how you will solve this? This all question we will solve by using the unitary method. Yes, in the previous chapters using this method, unitary method, we have solved many questions, and here we will also use this method to solve this type of question. So here we have to find the cost of 2 kilogram tomato. Clear? So from the table we have 1 kilogram tomato cost. So you will write here given from the table, cost of 1 kilogram tomato is 12 rupees, then we will find cost of 2 kilogram tomato is equal to 12 into 2, it means it is 24 rupees, and at last you can write hence cost of 2 kilogram tomato is 24 rupees. At last you can write the answer. Now come to the second question. Second question is find the cost of half kilogram tomato. So once again we will use unitary method. So given, you will write cost of 1 kilogram tomato was 12 rupees, and cost of half kilogram, yes, we will multiply. So 12 into 1 upon 2, so it will be 12 1 jar 12, I have written here, and upon 2, so you will write here 2 is equal to 6 rupees. So half kilogram tomatoes cost is 6 rupees. Now come to the next. C, find the cost of 2 and 2 whole 1 upon 2 kilogram tomato. So here we have a mixed fraction number. So first you have to solve this mixed fraction number into, yes, you can convert in improper fraction, or you can also split these numbers, means 2 whole 1 upon 2 is splitted here in 2 kilogram and half kilogram. It means first you have to find the cost of 2 kilogram tomato, then you can find half kilogram tomato. In previous question we have found it. So direct you can write cost of 2 kilogram tomato is 24 rupees and cost of half kilogram is 6 rupees, and at last you will add this cost of 2 and half kilogram tomato is equal to 24 plus 6 is equal to 30 rupees. In this way you got the cost of 2 and half kilogram tomato. Clear? Next we have question number D. So let's go to D number. Here is the question D. find the cost of 3 whole 1 upon 2 kilogram potato. So from the table you can get the cost of 1 kilogram potato. So first you have to write that given. Okay, this is method 1. So given you will write, and you know that 3 whole 1 upon 2 is equal to 3 kilogram plus half kilogram, that is split it. Now from the table we have taken that cost of 1 kilogram potato is equal to 10 rupees. Then cost of 3 kilogram potato will be, yes, 10 into 3 is equal to 30 rupees. How you will do this? Because here you have the cost of 1 and you are finding the value for many, means 3 kilogram. For that we are multiplying. So it is 30 rupees. Now you will find the half kilogram potato cost. So you will write cost of half kilogram potato cost is equal to 10 into half is equal to, it will be 5 rupees. So at last you will add this. So you will write cost of 3 and half kilogram potato is equal to 30 plus 5 is equal to 35 rupees. In this way you can solve this. Or if you want to solve this question in another method, so I have method 2 here. So how is it? It's very easy. Method 2 I have named it. So we know that 3 whole 1 upon 2, it is a mixed fraction number, so you can convert in improper fraction, and that will be 7 upon 2. How it will be? Just multiply 3 with 2, so 3 2 is 6, then plus 1 add, that is 7 upon 2. You got it. Now you will write the cost of 1 kilogram potato, that is 10 rupees. Now find cost of 3 and half kilogram, means 7 upon 2 kilogram potato is equal to 10 into 7 upon 2. So 10 7 is 70 upon 2 is equal to 35 rupees. So you can see that I have also used method 2 to solve this one questions. In this way you can solve other questions by using this method. Now another question, question E. Now we have to find the cost of 1 whole 1 upon 4 kilogram carrot. Clear? So we know that 1 whole 1 upon 4 kilogram is equal to 5 upon 4. You can convert this mixed fraction into improper fraction. Now you will write cost of 1 kilogram carrot is equal to 18 rupees. From the table we have taken this. Now cost of 1 whole 1 upon 4, it means 5 upon 4 kilogram is equal to 18 into 5 upon 4. So 18 5 is 90, 90 upon 4 is equal to 22.5 rupees. So it is the cost of 1 whole 1 upon 4 kilogram carrot. Clear? Now next question, we have question F. We have to find the cost of 4 whole 3 upon 4 kilogram gourd. Clear? So similarly it is just like previous solution, right solution. Then we know that 4 whole 1 upon 3 upon 4 is equal to 19 upon 4. How it will be? 4 4 is 16, 16 plus 3 19, 19 upon 4. It is an improper fraction. Now cost of 1 kilogram gourd is equal to 8 rupees. We have taken from the table. And now cost of 4 whole 3 upon 4 means 19 upon 4. So we'll multiply 8 into 19 upon 4. So it will be 152 upon 4. That is 38 rupees. So you can write at last, hence cost of 4 whole 3 upon 4 kilogram gourd is equal to 38 rupees. Now next question, we have a table. In blue table we have a list, that is potato, carrot and gourd. This is buying Kirti. Okay, so we have to find its total cost. That she is buying a potato 2 whole 1 upon 4 kilogram, carrot she is buying 3 whole 3 upon 4 kilogram, and gourd she is buying 1 whole 1 upon 2 kilogram. So total how much money Kirti will pay to the shopkeeper? Here is a question, how much Kirti will pay for this all? So let's start to solve it. So solution you will write first. Then first we have to find the cost for 2 whole 1 upon 4 kilogram potato. So 2 whole 1 upon 4 kilogram means 9 upon 4. So cost of 1 kilogram potato we have taken 10 rupees from the table, and you will multiply by 9 upon 4. So 10 9 is 90 upon 4. So 90 upon 4 means 22.5 rupees. You will divide it. Now cost for 3 whole 3 upon 4 kilogram. Carat, it means 15 upon 4 kilogram. So 18 rupees is the cost of 1 kilogram carat. So you will multiply this 18 with 15 upon 4. Then you will get 270 upon 4. So when you will divide this number, you will get 67.5 rupees. So this is the cost of 3 whole 3 upon 4 kilogram carat. And at last, we have to find 1 whole 1 upon 2 kilogram gourd. So 1 whole 1 upon 2 you have to convert in improper fraction, that is 3 upon 2. And now cost of 1 kilogram gourd is 8 rupees, so we have taken here and multiply by 3 upon 2. So it will be 24 upon 2. And when you will divide 24 by 2, you will get 12 rupees. And at last, we have found the total money for this all vegetables that we have, that Kirti will pay to the shopkeeper. So we will write, now total money for this all is equal to, first write 22.5 plus 67.5 rupees plus 12 rupees is equal to 102 rupees. It means the cost of the all vegetables that Kirti is buying is 102 rupees. And this amount Kirti will pay to the shopkeeper. And at last you can write, hence Kirti will pay 102 rupees to the shopkeeper. Have you understood this all? I hope that you have understand this all questions. And now come to the topic. Next we have, so A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Yes, till the G question we have solved this all questions. And H, here is another question. Make a bill of your own for vegetables you want to buy. Find the total money you will have to pay. So it is an activity, my dear students. You can do it at your home. And here is the table. You will arrange the items name here, their price per kilogram, and you will find their amount, what is the cost. And at last, here you will write the total amount of that all items. Clear? So in today's class, we studied about the types of fractions. So I repeat, there are today we have studied about the types of fractions. So there are three types of fractions we have studied. First was proper, second was improper fraction, and the third was mixed fraction. And at last, we found the cost of Kirti's shopping list. So that's all for today's class. Dear students, see you all in the next video. And I request to the all viewers, if this video was helpful for you, so please like, share, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Till then, bye-bye.